there, friends. I'm Jessica Lasaka, and welcome to Weak Sauce. Payless just pulled off a pretty great prank on fashion influencers in a social experiment for their brand new marketing campaign. The shoe retail chain invited a slew of fashion influencers to the launch of a brand new shoe brand called Palissy. The shoes on display ranged in price from $200 to $600. However, what the influencers did not know was that the shoes were actually just Payless shoes that normally retail for $20 to $40. When asked for their opinions on the new styles, attendees raved that they were sophisticated and stylish, and they could tell that the shoes were made out of quality materials.
And I could tell it was made with high quality material.
Palissy went on to sell over $3,000 worth of merchandise within the first 3 hours, but when it was revealed to the influencers that what they actually purchased were Payless shoes, they were refunded their money and allowed to take the shoes home for free. The whole point of the campaign was to prove that Payless shoes are just as stylish as designer shoes and that they are still a relevant place to shop. So we've all probably been around little kids who are constantly just picking stuff up off the floor and sticking it in their mouths. So in order to really feel for them, some pediatricians decided to swallow some Lego heads and see how long it took to pass through their body. A group of six pediatricians decided that they wanted to find out, so they conducted a study where each of them swallowed a Lego head and monitored their bowel movements over the next few days to see how long it took for the Lego head to pass through. Yes, that's right, these brave men and women searched through their poop over the next couple days to search for that little yellow head. Given the nature of the study, the doctors definitely had some fun with the terminology, calling the pre-ingestion bowel habit the stool hardness in transit score, aka the SHAT score, and the moment of discovery was referred to as the found and retrieval time, aka fart. From all the data that was gathered, it was found it takes approximately 1.71 days to pass through, and no digestive tract complications were reported. A Florida man decided he wanted to kick off his trip to Switzerland in the most extreme way possible by hang gliding. Chris Gursky traveled to Interlaken, where he hired a relatively new hang glider pilot to take him on his excursion. What ended up happening was upon takeoff, the hang glider pilot forgot to strap Chris's harness onto the hang glider. They then proceed to run off a 4,000-foot cliff when, to their horror, it is revealed that Chris isn't harnessed and he immediately begins to slip. He holds onto the hang glider and the pilot's leg for dear life for just under 3 minutes before they're able to safely land. Naturally, the video went viral because it's scary AF, and when asked about his experience, Chris simply replied he wants to try hang gliding again because his first experience was a bad one. You're a crazy man, Chris Gursky. A photo of a really big-ass cow in Australia went viral this week. The photo depicts a really big-ass black and white cow among a sea of little tiny itty-bitty brown cows. This said cow has been dubbed the Michael Jordan of cows, standing at a whopping 6'4", when the average height of a normal cow is 4.5 feet tall. However, technically this cow is not a cow at all, but a steer, because he's a male, and steers are generally taller than cows. However, steers usually top out at just under 6 feet, and this guy is 6'4", so he's still an anomaly. WTF. The giant steer, who also goes by the name of Knickers, is also exceptionally huge because he's really old. He's 7, and usually cows and steers are sent to the slaughterhouse by 3. His size actually ended up saving his life because now he's way too big to go to a processing facility, aka a slaughterhouse. So what's the point of this story, you might be asking? I don't know, it's just kind of cool that this cow is so big and we can't eat him. All right, guys, well, that's it for me. I'm Jessica Lasaka. Stay saucy!